Okay, the next in the series of one handmade tool is a texture tool made from a spring, and no, not a little trickle of water, made from a spring, a little coiled piece of wire. Now there's a whole lot of room for experimentation and play here. I made this one. I didn't like this one. One, the sticks are too close together, and the spring is really coarse, and it doesn't have any give, and it goes through the clay like a plow, so the thinner wire spring is better. This one I made, this is from a pen. I didn't like it. That one was too big, this one's too small. This one's kind of fun. I made this one from a faucet repair kit. It's still leaking. Anyway, this is from a faucet repair kit, and I like this one. Notice the sticks are a little further apart. But what you like in texture is what you like in texture. I like oranges better than I like apples, and I like the thicker texture better than the small one. The pen one made this little one, one that's kicking around here that I didn't show you made that one, and this one was made by the leaky tap spring that I liberated from home. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how these work. I've made a cylinder here, and it's thick. This cylinder probably is, I don't know, it's thick, an inch and a half thick. And I'm going to start cutting with the spring, but I like to give myself a start point. And I'm just going to go around here and take off a chunk and go all the way around. Again, I mentioned there's lots of room for experimentation. I'm wiggling the spring. You can see in a minute. As I'm wiggling through, maybe I'll do it over here. As I'm wiggling through, you can wiggle close together, wiggle far apart, go in deep, don't go that deep. And there's a whole lot of room for big spring, little spring, close wiggle, far apart wiggle, angle wiggle. There's a whole lot of play in there that you can do your own texture, your own way, your own thing. And I'm just going to go quickly around here. And as I said, this is quite thick, so I've got a lot of room, hopefully. And when I'm done this, I'll show you what to do next. Okay, so now I've got it all cut out. Now cut that out. I'm going to take my perfect profile rib. Check out One Handmade Tools. I'll tell you all about this. And anyway, I'm just going to open this up a little bit. And as you see, as I open, your texture changes quite a bit. Now I'm going to make this the same shape as that because I like that. And I'm just going to go in. If you don't have a rib, you can use your fingers. Now your fingers are also kind of good too, because you can kind of tell how thick this is with your fingertips. And I'm just going to pull out. This is kind of going wonky. Bring that back. Now it's really hard. You really want to, your hands want to work together, but I'm just going to give it a couple more pulls. It's going to get bigger. Define that, and as it spins, you can kind of get if the profile is straight. There's also a fine line of, as you're pushing it out, you can feel the inside of your clay is getting thinner and thinner, because I did take quite a bit out of there, and you can go all the way through so your sides burst open and the pot falls down. Ask me how I know. Anyway, play with it. Like I said, get a big spring, a little spring. Cut it angly, cut it straight, cut it deep, cut it shallow, and just have some fun with it. But I do like a pot to come up and finish. It has its texture that wraps around and goes, I'm done now.